Good evening. A very warm welcome to everybody from Disha. Our program is going to start in just a couple of minutes.
Good afternoon, all of you. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Bhanumati, welcome. Welcome, Bhanumati.
Good afternoon, Rekha.
Good afternoon, Rekha. Yeah, good afternoon, good afternoon. Nice to see you. Srilata is also there.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon,
Shashikiran. Yes, Subhaji. Welcome.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Nagesh here.
Good afternoon, Ji. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Very happy to see you.
Yeah, Nagesh Ji.
My pleasure. Namaste, Ji.
Namaste, Nagesh Ji.
Namaste, namaste, Subhu Ji.
Namaste, Subhu Ji.
Namaste. Tumba chanagide nimma asana.
Nimgala mundena.
ಅಂತ ಬರೀ ಶವಾಸನ ಒಂದು ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ
ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಟೀಮ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಲೈವ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಅವ್ರ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಲೈವ್ ಆನ್ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ಮೀರಾ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು
ಯಾ ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಆಮ್ ಐ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಹು ಆರ್ ಹಿಯರ್
Namaste.
Yes.
Namaste.
Yeah, wonderful. Thank you for the overwhelming response. Disha is very happy and delighted to host this program for you today. So before we start the program, I would like to mention that Disha, even though Disha is organizing this program, we have other players too for us today. They are going to conduct this program. First is Adhyatma Yoga. We have Subhu Bhaiyaji from Adhyatma Yoga, who is going to actually conduct the session for us today. So welcome, Subhuji.
Namaste. And
then, we also have Best University. As we speak, they are providing the technical support. Thanks to Chancellor Dr. Rupa Vasudevan and also Mr. Shazil. And I would like to thank Sri Aurobindo College and specifically Shailaja ma'am, who readily accepted to provide platform for us today, but for various reasons we couldn't take it up. But still she was ready. She said anything for me.
Rupa ji is there.
Welcome to you. Welcome to you, ma'am. Welcome to you, Dr. Rupa ji, for the session.
Yeah.
So before we start the session, I just want to share something very interesting. Just my my personal experience. See, before settling down in Basavagudi in the southern part of Bangalore, I was in somewhere near Whitefield in a gated community. We settled there in the year 2010, and every day in the evening I would see so many grandpas and grandmas, elderly people, taking a leisurely stroll, walk with a stick in the hand. It used to be a common sight. But 5 years down the line, one day I distinctly remember around 6 o'clock when I went out to take something. I had something, so I went out. I saw that, 3 or 4 ajjis, they were actually dressed in t-shirt and track pants, and they were briskly walking towards a clubhouse with mat in their hands. I was very curious. Ajji, yen idu anta? I asked them, and then 2-word response came from them. They said, yoga class. Wow. I said, okay. So when I was probably busy with my personal and professional life, many things have changed. So now, Ajji, instead of leisurely walks, they have all started going to yoga class. Wow, that's a wonderful sign. So even today, when I talk to many youngsters, many college goers, they are very much into yoga. There are many students who are very good in yoga. They attend yoga classes. They know all the benefits of yoga. When I ask them why yoga, they tell me, ma'am, memory power, it enhances my breath, it helps this beauty quotient, all that answers. And interestingly, I also get other responses as well. Ma'am, yoga is a trend, ma'am, it's a fashion, ma'am, yoga is a style, ma'am. I get those kinds of responses too. Now I wonder, right from the age 8 to 18, this yoga has attracted everybody. How did it happen?
Praveen.
And that too, it's a recent development. How did this happen?
So, basically,
at this moment, we cannot help think and thank our Prime Minister Narendra Modi for actually proposing yoga in the UN and proposing June 21st as an International Yoga Day. We have to thank him for that. So this was a wonderful move, a masterstroke move, because it not only made the entire world turn their heads towards yoga, but also towards our country, India, as well. So they started taking yoga as well as India seriously. Now you might be wondering, what has Disha, which is an NGO giving value education to students, got to do with yoga? Suddenly, why yoga? Because this is the first time we are celebrating yoga in this fashion, Yoga Day, the eve of yoga in this fashion. So why? How? Let me tell you, your Disha, as you all know, we offer workshops on the theme of know yourself, know your country, know your culture. Yoga is very much part of Disha for many, many reasons. But I just want to highlight 3 main reasons. The first one is, know your country. We talk a lot about our country, and yoga is the pride of India. one of the biggest contribution of India to the entire world. So it is almost like know your country, know your yoga. So Disha has something with yoga. Second thing is, reason is, Disha, we sensitize the students on 5 quotients through our programs: physical, emotional, intellectual, social, and spiritual. So let me tell you what other means, better means can it be to enhance the physical quotient for students. Other so that's the best way, and we have seen how the students enjoy our yoga sessions. And the third reason is, so we always in Disha, we believe in holistic development, complete well-being of the students. So that also includes the physical body aspect as well. So we completely in Disha, we understand the connection between body, mind and soul. And the tool, the best tool that we all have with us is our body. The one of the most complex tool that we have today, and we have to take care of it. So the well-being, the physical well-being also affects our emotional feelings, our thought process and everything, even our lifestyle. So it is very important that we give that yoga, that physical quotient for our students. So these are the main important reasons why Disha has many things to do, has a deeper connection with yoga. So now, having said that, today for the first time, we are celebrating Yoga Day in a big way like this, with the support of all our participants who are here and all the volunteers who are here, yoga experts that we have here. So I would like to welcome you to Professor Acharya Subramaniam Ananta Venkata Ji. Now wondering who this is? It is none other than our Subbu Bhaiya, our Subbu Ji, as we know him. So nobody knows him with by any other name other than Subbu Ji, or as our beloved Subbu Bhaiya Ji. So he is here with us today. So Subbu Bhaiya is he has conducted so many programs in colleges. He has programs in TV. He has conducted so many national and international conferences on yoga as well. So everybody knows him. And basically, he's an engineering graduate who decided to pursue his passion in yoga. And not just that, he went on to do his MSc in yoga from Esvyasa University. He completed his doctorate in yoga meditation science from the Hindu University America from Florida, the USA. And he has worked for more than a decade with the Esvyasa University in different capacities, including as a senior faculty, heading the cultural and the spiritual activities for them as well. Currently, he is a founder director of Adhyatma Yoga, which conducts lot of yoga programs, continuous training sessions, and public programs. With many experts. They join hands with many yoga experts and they conduct programs, including the one that is going on right now, a popular online session, Kapi with Yogi, a very popular program, Talk of the Town. So your Subbu Bhaiya is conducting. So more than that, I would also like to add that he is also well known for his oratory skills. His talk on spirituality and meditation, yoga, he has given talks in many colleges, in many programs, in public platform as well. But if you have attended his session, you would also agree that he has a great sense of humor with which he can make the program very interactive, very interesting and highly successful one. So let us welcome a multifaceted personality who is with us today. Yoga Ratna, Sri Subbu Bhaiya Ji, welcome, sir. You're on mute, sir. Subbu Bhaiya, you're on mute.
Namaste, Meera Ji. I thought you're going to take over the one full hour session only talking Subbu Purana.
You deserve that introduction, sir.
Thank you that you have given too much, I think, expectation. I should fulfill that. I do not know. So as he rightly said, here is the kapi with the yogi. Kapi is kashaya, atmiya, personal interaction with a yogi. And I'm the kapi talking to the yogis, you people. Meera ji, we shall start.
Yes, having yes sir, we are ready to start the session. Are the volunteers ready? Can we ask the all the participants? Sorry, so all the participants ready?
Are you ready?
Yes. Are you all ready?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. That's wonderful. Yes,
it looks like I have come for an examination here. We have all wonderful people, great yogis, Yogacharya Shri Nagesh ji is here, Suma amma is here, and Pradeep, Pramod, and you know Sneha ji, who always tests me a lot, and all people are here in this session. So that makes me nervous. And wait 1 minute, my PPT is somewhere getting.
And at this point, I would also like to add that the entire Disha team is here, including our organizer secretary, Srimati Rekha Ramchandran. She is also here with us today.
Yes, we would welcome everybody by giving a beautiful clap. Yeah, the PPT is ready and open. Yeah.
Is there Disha in here?
So Meera ji, I go to this present now, and I think I can take the PowerPoint, right?
Yes, yes, sir.
Present now, yeah, and yes, I have the PPT here. Are you able to see the slide now?
Yes, yes, Subbu Bhaiya ji, we are able to see the slide. Yes.
Do you see me also?
Yes, we see both.
Okay, fine. Because I am not able to see any of you. Usually, I know it's better if I see everybody and do it. And I don't see any of you here, so I presume that you're all watching me. And
very much.
Yes, and Rekha ji has, you know, told that today's theme should be, you know, from self to selfless, from Vyashti to Samashti.
Subbu ji, sorry for the interruption. Subbu ji, you can make other scene. You can change that option is there.
Okay.
In the three dots, you can change the view.
How is that? I'm not able to see. Okay. No, this is the slide. Okay. PPT, but where do I see you? Okay, this side, three dots. Okay, more options. Nageshi, you are telling how do I change the layout? Is it like
you have to there are three dots as you go up. Okay, then you change the layout.
Yeah,
the first one you select.
Okay,
there you can see all others also. You can either select the first one or the third one is more. Okay. You can see more people.
Okay, I want to see more people, that's better.
third one.
Okay. But I think that this doesn't give us a video, right? It's only audio in Google Meet.
If people have opened their video, you can see video also.
Subhashi, when you are presenting your slides, you won't be able to see anybody else. So that's how it is. So please present your slides, but we will be able to see you. You alone won't be able to see others.
Okay. That's fine. So, okay. I'll go to that. There's some sound here, noise. Yeah, I think I go here. So welcome you all for this wonderful webinar on yoga organized by Disha, and I'm always part of Disha, so to the same family doesn't need any much introduction. Meera ji spoke very well about the International Day of Yoga and how today, you know, right from young people to the elders, everybody have taken a keen interest in doing yoga. Right, the Ajis as well as the modern people, everybody have taken a keen interest in yoga, and that is a wonderful thing what we see today. If this has happened, you know, of course, thanks to the Prime Minister that he had taken it to the world over, but all the great yoga masters, starting from Maharishi Patanjali, you know, Vyasa, Vasishta, the entire yoga parampara, and which in the modern time, it was taken to the great level by Swami Vivekananda, by the teaching of four streams of yoga. And then we had all the great masters, Sri Krishnamachari, BKS Iyengar, our Guruji Dr. H.R. Nagendra Ji, and Ramdev Baba, Sri Sri and Sadhguru. Thanks to all these masters who collectively came together and, you know, who brought this declaration of the Yoga Day, June 21st, much before even this government could take over in the year 2011, the declaration of Yoga Day, people, many are from Bangalore today, you will be surprised to know, it happened in Bangalore in the year 2011, December 3 and 4. In Bangalore it happened. All the yogis came together, they signed the 21st of June should be the Yoga Day. Now tell me if anybody can say, because we have announced that there is going to be a yoga quiz also, you know, I will take the quiz parallelly, though we have the quiz master here, Sri Pramodji, with us, but I would, you know, parallelly take the quiz. I want to know, can anybody say why this 21st of June is taken to be the Yoga Day? Who is going to say?
It is longest day.
Who said it?
It is the longest day.
Yeah, longest day. Okay. Why the longest day should be taken as Yoga Day? Don't we have any other day connected to yoga? Like Patanjali's birthday it could have been, or the day in which yoga was started, it could have, why the day of longest day has taken to be the Yoga Day?
More sunlight is received.
More sunlight, okay. Go ahead, please go ahead. Yeah, this.
Surya Namaskar is important for yoga.
Surya Namaskar is important in yoga. Okay, very nice. What else? Why Surya Namaskar is important? Anybody else? Other than our Disha core team members, others, other than the volunteers, the other students and other teacher participants can share. Come on. I see a lot of, you know, wonderful students from various colleges, various faculty members. All are here. You should share quickly. It's all because, you know, even yoga is all about nature, connecting with us, the nature, internal and external, bringing together is what yoga is all about. Right. So the external nature, as you see, the panchabhutas, what we have, and that has a deeper connection with Surya. Without Surya, there is no energy in the nature as such. Right. We don't get plants to bring out the oxygen, nor we don't get fresh air for us to breathe in and breathe out. And we don't have light without the sun being there. And for us to live, Surya is a primordial source of energy. It is very much required for, you're able to hear me now? Hello?
Ah, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, fine. Yes. I'll go to them. I think there is some sound disturbance there. So the sun is the primordial source of energy, right? Similarly, in this physical body also, we see that this body is made out of the panchabhutas, the five elements. First is akasha, then vayu, which is wind, then agni, which is fire, and water, the apahar jala element, and prithvi, the earth, which is there. So the pancha koshatmaka sharira, what we see, has the pancha bhuta also. So what we see externally in the nature as such is what is there within our human body also. So by doing yoga, we control the nature internal and external. So within us, you know, bringing the balance of the five elements, that's what yoga tries to make us. And similarly, outside also, we see there are a lot of calamities and disturbances which keep happening. So how we can, you know, take care of ourselves in coordination with the prakriti, with the nature. That is what yoga is all about. So yoga is all about connecting nature. And for the entire nature, the common connecting point is Surya, sun. So this is one of the reasons that if you see in all yogic postures, right? I'm sure you all have been doing yoga at some time or other time. Can you name a few asanas, name of the few yoga postures randomly, quickly, everybody? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Vrikshasana, Parvatasana, Adhomukhasvanasana.
Hey, Obrebeda, not one person. One should say one, the other person should say something. Yeah, Vrikshasana, very good. Yeah. Go ahead, others, come on.
Vajrasana.
Super, next. Chakrasana. Super, next, come on.
Padmasana.
Super, next, keep going. So, louder, fast.
Ushtrasana.
Yeah, great.
Shavasana.
Super, that is a universal
name. Chandrasana.
Yes.
Mayurasana.
Super.
Baddha Kodasana.
Shalabhasana.
Shalabhasana.
Paschimottasana.
Super.
Sarvangasana,
yes.
Padmasana.
Padmasana, wonderful. Now when you listen to all these names, very good, thank you. The names are so many. We have 84 lakhs of asanas, my dear. 84 lakhs of asanas. Why these many 84 lakhs of asanas? Because there is an asana named after every species in the creation. And we have 84 lakhs of species according to our Indian scriptures. And science also agreed to that. So that's why you see an asana named everything after a dog, after rabbit, after lion, after tiger, after tree. Even something like even after after the hill, the parvata. So yoga is all about connecting with nature. So the ancient yogis, they lived a nature-friendly life, an eco-friendly life. And whatever they saw in the nature, they connected with that. So their, Vyashti, their individual personality is always connected with the cosmic energy, the cosmos around. That is something very important in yoga that we remember. That's why in this, day of yoga, the International Day of Yoga, which is declared on 21st of June, because it is the longest, day. It is the summer solstice, the longest day. Therefore, we have taken the International Day of Yoga. Are you all able to see me here? If you're able to see me, then you can see a screen behind me. The International Day of Yoga's logo is there. Or even on the slide which I have shared, you have the International Day of Yoga's logo, which is there. You see in the center, the blue colored, yogi's image with the hands up, raised up. That is the individual, the Vyashti, who is there, right? And all around, you see the Samashti, the Jagat, which is there. The Pancha Bhutas are represented there, actually. You see the Prithvi, the earth, actually, in the blue color thing around. The earth is there, India map, the earth is there, Yoga Bhumi. And then you see the space around it, the sky. And then the fire is represented in yellow in color. And the blue color thing here is representing the water element. And you have air represented with the greenery shown around. So that is how the Pancha Bhutas are that which is connected within us and all around us. So yoga brings us union. As we say, yoga is a union, the connection between we, the individual, with the cosmos. So this is something which we need to remember. And when we move ahead today, we just see today in today's society, a lot of advanced developments have started happening. Externally, we have so much that we have grown, that we have a lot of sophistication. Technology has grown up so much that, you're all spread in different places. But from different places, we are today connected together and we are conducting the yoga day through just keeping the laptop or the cell phone in front of us. To this extent, the technologically we are advanced, but how as a human that we are grown today? Now, a lot of problems that we still face. I just in this context remember a story. Once it so happened, an explorer. Explorer is somebody, not your Windows Explorer or something. It is the Vasco da Gama, Columbus kind of people who goes country to country exploring new places. He was caught by a group of cannibals in some dense forest. The cannibal group thought, wow, we got good food for our king today. They took this person to the king, the explorer, and the king saw him. Oh, you are an explorer. Very nice. Where did you come from? The explorer says, oh, I came from the United States of America. Is it? Even I had been to the United States of America and I did my studies PG there. This explorer was surprised. He said, come on, you say you studied in the US, but still you are a cannibal, you are eating man. He said, so what? I learned how to use the fork and the knife. This is how, my dear friends, as Disha always says, we are externally developing all these, but internally what has to happen, that is what we are missing. So yoga brings you that. So in Swami Vivekananda said in the you know, he has a faith in the future of the nation. But today what is happening? The agony of stress in the younger generation, the modern times, is increasing more with more pain and misery. What happened just within a week's time, we see an young upcoming star, you know, with all his dreams, but for whatsoever reason had to commit suicide. And a week much before that, in our own state in Karnataka, a film star had a heart attack and he died at young age. Why all these are happening, right? And world over today, we are facing the contemporary situation of the COVID infection, which is happening. We're today talking of a lot of immunity and all those things. So what is the way out? How can we come out from all this agony of stress, of depression, of the lack of immunity and all this viral infection, everything? Is there a common solution? That's where yoga, which is a multidimensional approach, it can help us, of course, not only to solve students' problem, but for the whole humanity, this has become the way to help us. So this is where we need to understand a bit about how health is today, because I took this because we are in the scenario where all of our health is in a kind of question mark. We think that I am all right, I am better, I am healthy. So why should I wear the mask? Why should I, not go out and, go out to walk or play or anything? So everybody, we are having this kind of a scenario. That's where we should understand health is not mere absence of illness or disease, but health is a state of well-being at the physical. Yeah, physically I am strong. I don't have any infection and corona cannot come and affect me, we may think. But, mentally also it affects us. Come on, that, kind of lockdown period, 2 months. We had good time being at home and family, but a lot of uncertainties. What is going to happen? Schools, will they get opened or not? Will I get back my job or not? Am I going to be paid full salary or salaries are going to be cut? A lot of problems. And many people, are having social difficulties also. The social well-being is at a question mark. And of everything, the definition of health by WHO says, you require the spiritual level of well-being also in your health. That's why in Disha, always the boosting of the physical quotient, mental quotient, emotional quotient, which is required for the social well-being. And they go also to boost the spiritual level. So yoga is one common point to bring all these levels of overall development of our personality. So let's see what yoga is. I would take this definition of yoga today, though there are multiple definitions of yoga. Vasishta, in the Yoga Vasishta, says yoga is a skill or technique to calm down the mind. Manah prashamana upayaha yoga ityabhidhiyate. Yoga is a technique to calm down the mind. When you say this, mind is something, we always say, I said the kapi, mind is the kapi. It's a monkey mind. It keeps jumping from, thought to thought, like tree, like monkey keeps jumping from tree to tree. Mind either flies to the past or flows to the future, doesn't stay in the present. So the mind is the biggest challenge. Even now in this COVID-19 situation, if you see, you have a better immune power, your respiration is better, you don't have any symptoms and anything, right? But sometimes the virus, when it comes, all around it is going there. So if your mind is not strong enough, if you're not having wonderful positive thoughts in your mind, then you can become positive with corona. So positive can be either this way or that way. So that is one tricky thing that was happening. So we need to keep the mind in a very wonderful calm situation. So always mind keeps thinking of all negativities and worrying. So yoga tells we need to bring the mind to a kind of a calmness that is very important. So mana prashamana upayaha yoga ityabhidhiyate. In this context, always, I remember a story of two women who were staying opposite to each other in an apartment. One day this lady, said, she comes out and then she is seeing it from the balcony in the opposite house. The lady Y is hanging the clothes. The lady Z, when she sees the clothes of the opposite house lady, she sees her clothes to be very dirty, very ugly, shabby. She is feeling bad for her, pity for her. She calls her husband and says, come on, see, look at the opposite house. The lady who is putting the clothes, or her clothes are looking very dirty. I think I should ring her and tell her the technique of our house, that, madam, why do you take the trouble of washing the clothes yourself? You can take the help of your husband as I do in our house. That's what it happened, my dear friends, during the lockdown. We, families, couples were not only made for each other, they became mates for each other. So the husband used to wash the clothes here. So he says, come on, my dear, why do you tell our house story to the opposite house? Let them do whatever they want to do. Don't tell all this. So, but week after week, when Madam Z comes and sees Madam Y, she is always tempted to look at her clothes. Her looks, her clothes are dirty. She want to call her, ring her and tell her the secret of her clothes shining better. But one Sunday morning, perhaps on 21st of June tomorrow, which is a Sunday, when she goes and stands on the balcony and sees her clothes, she sees there the clothes of Madam Y is looking better shining than her clothes. She is really surprised. She calls her husband, come here, Henry. Her husband comes running. What happened? What happened? See there, her clothes are shining better than my clothes. I think she has not washed the clothes. I think her husband has washed the clothes, or maybe she has changed from the Rin soap to the Patanjali soap. You know, something has happened like that. Then her husband says, no, my dear, I do not know whether they have, whether she has washed, her husband washed, whether it is Rin soap or Patanjali soap, or whether it is a washing machine or washing man, I do not know. But I have washed the glass windows of our balcony very well today. So, you know where the problem was. Every time she was looking through the dirt in her balcony, therefore the clothes were looking dirty for her. That is how, my dear friends, our mind is something which is corrupted. We say, manayeva manushyanam karanam bandaha mokshayoho. Mind is that which through which we are becoming bounded, and using the same mind, yoga helps us techniques to come out of this bondage and take out the miseries and go to an excellent state of equilibrium, the balanced state of mind. So yoga is a technique to calm down the mind and cleanse the mind, and we need to go ahead. So when you say this, yoga offers you wonderful, you know, practice, a set of the Ashtanga yoga. Often today, many people practice only Kashtanga yoga, the, you know, the strainers of the body, you know, straining the body too much and doing, but yoga is not only about that. Yes, asana is definitely an important part of the yoga. Without asana, you can't do pranayama. Without asana, you can't do dhyana. Without asana, pratyahara, samadhi, anything you can't do. At the same time, asana alone doesn't make it complete in yoga. I always tell, like in the food, you know, when the when you go to a grand meal, they serve every other thing, dish, you know, the kosambari, the palliya, the payasam, everything they serve. We wait until white rice is served, right? Without white rice, you can't eat anything else. But white rice alone, you can't eat it, right? That is how it is. White rice is an essential component of the food. Without the rice, you can't take the other thing. You can't just drink sambar or rasam. It has to go with the rice. Similarly, asana yoga is something like that. It has to go with all other things. So asana is a base, the foundation upon which you have to do different things. So Patanjali gives us a beautiful, you know, set of practices, which is yama, not the god of death, but it is the don'ts. What we say, the five yamas, as you see, are ahimsa, non-violence, satya, not lying, and do not follow falsehoodness, asteya, do not steal others' things, and brahmacharya is do not indulge in the sense pleasures, aparigraha, do not accumulate more than what is required, not grabbing. So these are the yamas, which are the don'ts. So this is connecting you with the other person. Don't hurt others. Do not lie to others. You know, of course, be truthful to yourself. Don't hurt yourself is also very important. Same time, others. So this is kind of your interpersonal relationship, you and the others. So yoga is, you know, telling you how you have to deal with yourself and the people around you. In family, it could be. It could be in our office. It could be in the society. It could be in the nation. How we should deal ourselves, right? Actually, during this time of COVID-19 lockdown, there was a very good time for us to apply all these things. You know, yama, do not hurt not only you, others. If you get the infection, you should do the self-quarantine. You should not go and, you know, kill others. You should not, you know, spread the virus to others. This is the wonderful ahimsa which you have to follow. Satya, hello. Satya, which is truthfulness. Be truthful to, you know, yourself. If you had the infection, declare it. There are many people who are hiding, you remember? So satya. So even this COVID time brings us all reassurance of the wonderful yama niyama. And of course, aparigraha. Do not accumulate what is required. What is, you know, more than what is required. So we took only the essential things. The Prime Minister appealed to us. Take the essential things and maintain yourself for all these days. That's how aparigraha we are, you know, kind of leading. Many people during this lockdown have reduced one meal a time a day and come to two meal and all. So this is wonderful practice of aparigraha, what we do. Similarly, niyama is our self-individual discipline. So yama is you and the society. you know, the Vyashti and the Samashti together, Yama is something that connects. And Niyama is the individual growth of yourself, which is Saucha, the cleanliness. Not only the external cleanliness of the body, but internal of the mind, of the speech that we do. Kaya, Vacha, Manasa. When we talk the Patanjali, when we talk of Patanjali's mantra in yoga, Yogena Chittasya Padena Vacham, Malam Sharirasya Chavaidyakena, Yopa Karotam, Pravara Muni Nam, we say. So it is that Sharira, the Mala in the Sharira to be removed, cleansing of body is required. Yoga has wonderful techniques for that. And the cleanliness of the speech, what we do, for that grammar, of course, what again Patanjali has contributed, it is very much required. And the cleanliness of our mind, which is more important, yogena chittasya. So yoga is a technique to cleanse our mind for chitta shuddhi, chitta vritti nirodaha and chitta shuddhi he is going to give through the practice of yoga. So first is saucha, which is cleanliness, which is very important, and santosha, the contentment, tapas, which is the austerity, which is forbearing the difficulties. Now lockdown is a tapas. The quarantine is a tapas. You know, social distancing is a tapas. These are all the tapas. So you have difficulty now. Forbear the difficulty for the betterment in the future, what is going to happen. People want instant pleasures. Right now, what I see, I want immediately. This is the young people's, you know, tendency. So we need to overcome that. That is what tapas is. And swadhyaya, which is the self-introspection study of our own self with the help of the guru, the help of the shastras. And that is what swadhyaya. And we attain, you know, the state of Ishvara Pranidhana, understanding the human limitation. That we have the cosmic entity, the energy, the universal, you know, supreme reality which is there, and we need to surrender ourselves, understanding the human limitation. Now we all thought we can do this, that, all those things. We had our own plans. But see, imagine one small virus came and upset everything. Now what do we have? We don't have a control over it. So that is where we surrender to the divine will, accept, and then see what the other opportunities are there. A yogi always look into the challenges and makes it into opportunity and takes a divine support for that. Taking the divine support is the Ishvara Pranidhana. As I told in the beginning, so we have the Pancha Bhutas which are there, the Akasha, the space which is there, from where the Vayu, Agni and the water and Prithvi. So this is the kind of macrocosm what we have. And in this human body, we have the microcosm which is having the Annamaya Kosha, the human body, Pranamaya Kosha or vital energy, Manomaya Kosha, the mind, Vijnanamaya Kosha, the intellect, and Anandamaya Kosha, which is our beautiful soul which is there. So there is an interconnection between the both. So in the context of I as an individual, the Vyashti, and the Panchabhutas in the Samashti, yoga connects you to that. And of course, there is an interconnection to the Panchakoshas and Panchabhuta. Not much time for us to do. We need to do some practice also. So in general, so yoga is something. Through all this process I told you, through the Ashtanga yoga, you know, of course I did not go ahead in I was telling you about the Yama Niyama, and then you have the asana, which is the most important limb of yoga, where we do the physical postures and make our body to be more strong and preparing it for the higher layers of the dhyana, pranayama and everything. And pranayama, as we know, it's a control of the pranic energy, the vital force. Through various techniques, it helps us to enhance the inner strength, the inner energy engineering that happens through pranayama. And dharana is that intense, you know, focusing, which is which will improve the kind of concentration in us. That goal setting is what is dharana in yoga. And dhyana is to be with your own self, forgetting all external disturbances, that one point of connecting yourself with yourself. You know, that is the thing. When you are within yourself, you know, that is the wonderful experience of dhyana which happens. And dhyana is something that we can't do, but it happens. When you prepare yourself for all those, that antaranga yoga of dhyana happens. And when that individuality that I am doing this also goes away, you become one with that cosmic entity. You become one with that Paramatma. This Jivatma, the individual self, becomes one with that Paramatma. And that when this Vyashti becomes one with the Samashti is what is Samadhi in yoga. That's how the beautiful Ashtanga yoga that we see is there. So yoga in general, we take you, this individual, from your normal level to great level, super level, divine level, and then to the cosmic personality. You become one with the cosmos, or from your Vyashti, you become one with the Samashti in the journey of yoga. This is what ultimately happens, my dear friends. And now it's time for us to
having understood all these, we need to go to some practice. Yeah, shall we all practice some yoga?
Yes, sir.
Are you with me? You're able to hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Very nice. Very nice. So, I would like to once see your presence and faces. I don't know. I will just come out of the. How do I see you all? It's not with Google. Yeah. Okay. Very nice. Wow. We have 73 people with us, and many of our Disha's yoga volunteers are going to be are with us. We are going to show some yoga postures and going to teach you. And we want you also to do. How many of you can do with us now? Join with us to do the yoga. Oh, there are many questions also. Okay, I'm seeing the questions here. Right, very nice. That's good. So nice. We will take it up in the end. Me and my Guruji Raghuramji will be there. We will take up all your questions. Very good. Of course, Bhavana had also answered, I believe. Abhishek ji put to the questions in the end. We will ask. Very good, Abhishek Pandey. Please keep putting your questions. Very nice. We will take up the questions and definitely answer all those. Now, shall we practice? Yes. Now, I want you all to be ready for some of the practices. We will guide you through some of the practice our instructors will do. And as we do, you can join with us in the practice. So let me again go back to my slide and have a kind of a quiz for you. So what do you see here? Who's going to say? A blurred image, of course. I have purposely done that so that you can identify. Who's going to say hello? Did you see the slide? Did you not see the slide? Sorry, Ram.
Subhuji, we were not able to see your slide.
Okay, I'll come back. I think.
Yes.
Okay, present now. I'm not much used to Google Meet using that, so I wish I should have shared to you before. It was some technical that we had something, so I couldn't share it. Are you able to see now?
Yes.
What do you see? Who is going to say?
Timakka.
Timakka. Which Timakka? Pakkad mane Timakka na?
Salu Marada Timakka.
Salu Marada Timakka. Very good. Let's give a good clap. Who said it?
Soumya.
Soumya. Very good, Soumya. Very nice. So when you see Salu Marada Timakka, what do you remember?
Tree.
Trees, right?
Alad
Mara. Yes, I don't know. Yav Mara Akidara Gotilla and Namsishir slide Akita Hele Mara Akidare. So, how she had planted trees, and our Pramod would always share wonderful insights about Salamara Timakka. How nicely she had been taking care of the children, the trees as their children, right? That is how always our people cared for the nature, right? So, when we see Salamara Timakka, what in yoga that you are remembering, my dear friends? Who can say?
Sir, karma tree yoga. Posture.
Huh?
Karma yoga.
Vrikshasana.
Karma yoga.
Aswath.
Huh?
Aswath.
Aswath, very good. Wonderful. That's a good thing, karma yoga, of course. Because that's what, she put self to selfless. She, in fact, totally had forgotten her selfishness and became one with the selfless nature. And that's what is called karma yoga. Yoga karmasu kaushalam. Very nice, Ashwath. And any posture particularly you remember? Any asana somebody was telling?
Vrikshasana.
Vrikshasana. Very good. Who said it?
Ashwath.
And you were held bardo. Wherever held beko. Everybody said.
Subhuji, Soumya also said. Vrikshasana.
Soumya also said. Yes, Soumya. Very good. So it is?
And sir, I remember tree posture.
Yeah, tree posture is, good. That's good, of course. We should tell it in Sanskritam. The original name is Vrikshasana, right? When we say Vriksha, so that is more profound. So, in fact, in yoga, somehow to teach the Western people, we have taken all English names. So slowly we should go back to, they are telling today, they don't say sun salutation. They say Surya Namaskara. They say Namaste, we want to shake hand. That's the problem here. Very nice, Soumya. So it is the Vrikshasana, you remember. So we are going to do the Vrikshasana. And who is going to show the Vrikshasana from our Disha team? I think Sumaka is there. So Bhavana?
Yes, I will present Vrikshasana. Yes,
so Sumaka will demonstrate Vrikshasana. Let's see it. Now we can do along with her. Okay, let's start doing also. I'm going to do with her, so you can also join. Yeah.
Subhuji, just do we have to learn introduction about the presenter, the volunteer yoga expert?
Yeah, yeah. So you can tell about Sumaka.
Okay. So Sumaka is a very, very active volunteer in Disha. And she was actually working after finishing her graduation, post-graduation in physics, she was working as a lecturer in college. And she was a banker for more than 25 years. And she's a life skill trainer, counselor. And recently I came to know that she has a big one more phase of Sumaka, a new avatar, which is yoga expert. So we have very happy to have Sumaka here with us today. Sumaka, welcome to the session.
Yes.
Thank you.
Not Risa, yoga, she being a yoga expert is for years together. And along with her, Sri Nageshji, who is her better half. We always say, wife has a better half. I would say now, Nageshji, the better half with Sumaji, both of them together. If you see the whole lockdown, when the lockdown started, the classes were stopped, but Nageshji and Sumaka did not stop the class. Every day they were doing at home and it was live to the Facebook. And if I do not know whether anybody else joined them, I was joining from Adhyatma Yoga with them and I was also practicing yoga with Sumaka and Nageshji.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yes. Now we'll see.
Can you see my screen?
No, not. Not it, Bhavana.
Can you see it now? Yeah, go ahead. We see play it. Maybe it should come. The only audio is coming, Bhavana. Video is not shown.
Oh, just give me a minute. I will present again. I'm not able to present now. Sorry for the technical issue. I'm present now. Option is stopped for me. Lavanya?
Yes, I'm checking as we speak, Bhavana.
Yeah, can you please present? My present now has ceased.
Yeah. Okay, just a second.
Others will ask Sumaka to live do it. She can do it.
No, we have it.
It's come.
Okay.
ವೃಕ್ಷಾಸನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟ್ರೀ ಪೋಸ್. ಒಂದು ಮರ ತನ್ನ ಬೇರುಗಳನ್ನ ಭೂಮಿಯೊಳಗೆ ಆಳವಾಗಿ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಪಾದವನ್ನು ನೆಲದ ಮೇಲೆ ದೃಢವಾಗಿ ಉರಿ ನಿಲ್ಲಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಏಕಾಗ್ರ ಚಿತ್ತತೆಯಿಂದ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ವಿತ್ ಫುಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಕಣ್ಣ ಎದುರಿಗೆ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಬಿಂದುವಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗಮನವನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿರುವಂತ ಆಸನ ಇದು. ಬೇಸಿಕಲಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಸನ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಏಕಾಗ್ರ ಚಿತ್ತತೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಮುಖ್ಯ. ಈಗ ಪಾದಗಳನ್ನು 2-3 inches ಅಗಲವಾಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಇವಾಗ ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಎಡಗಾಲನ್ನ ಎತ್ತಿ ಬಲತೊಡೆಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ಎಡಪಾದದ ಹಿಂಬದಿಯನ್ನ ಆದಷ್ಟು ಪೆರಿಯಾಗಿ ತಾಕ್ಸುತ್ತಾ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ನೋಡುತ್ತ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಸುದ್ದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಭಂಗಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದಾಗ ಒಂದು 30 ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಗಳ ಕಾಲ ದೃಢವಾಗಿ ನಿಂತ್ಕೋಬೇಕು. ಬಲಗಾಲನ್ನು ಎತ್ತಿ ಎಡತೊಡೆಯ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮುಂದುವರಿಸ್ಕೋಪ ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ
ಬಲಗಾಲನ್ನು. I think you all join and we'll do also. Watching her, you will also do. Yes. Very nice. That was very nice of Sumaka to do. We will give a good clap for Sumaka for doing this.
Thank you.
Now we will see what Vrikshasana is and how we can do and how it can help us better. What happened to my slide? So so what happens when we do Vrikshasana, or the as it is written, the tree pose, you know? So it gives a balance for the whole body, it strengthens the muscles and builds up the stamina and increases the focus and induces the patience in us. When we say tree, what we say, you know, tarorabhi sahishnuna, the sahishnuta, the patience which is the tree which is having, you know, it gives us everything. Right from the root to the fruit of the tree, every part of the tree is very useful to the mankind, right? And you go and cut it, pluck its fruits or leaf, it is patiently standing there. That's how we need to learn the patience and imbibe that in our life, which is very important, is what the tree is. Right? The tree is, that is how the Vrikshasana is telling us. So that's how in nature, you know, yoga connects you with the nature through all the simple postures. Not only it makes our body to become stronger, but also it makes our body to be connected with the mind, and then the mind with the soul, and the soul with the entire cosmos. So we will see the next posture. Who is this? Whom do we see here? Who's going to say? Are you able to hear me, everyone?
Yes. We are able to hear you.
Yes. From the participants, you are able to see the slide here?
No. Yes, sir.
I am not able to see the slide, sir.
Oh, I was showing you the slides. Ishtatila number.
The Vrikshasana was there. We were able to see the Vrikshasana slide.
Benefits of Vrikshasana.
Wait a minute. Let me go to, this is Google, present now, window, slide, share.
Subhuji, could you? Thank you.
You're able to see now?
Yes, we are able to see.
Now, who is going to say, who is this?
Kautilya.
Kautilya. Anybody else?
Bhaskaracharya.
Bhaskaracharya. Anybody else? Any other?
Aryabhatta.
Yes. Aryabhatta. So we should ask our quiz masters, either Pramoji or Sneha Didi, to confirm the answer whether is right. Can we give a good mark? Pramoji? Is Pramod there?
Yes, yes, correct answer.
Correct answer, yes. So Aryabhatta, very good. So what is that when you look at Aryabhatta, what is that you get connected? Like the way when you saw Salamaratimaka, you remember trees. So what is that you think of when you think of Aryabhatta, what you can think of? Anybody
India's
to answer?
First satellite.
India's?
First satellite.
That is named after Aryabhatta. Good. But what is the original contributions of Aryabhatta?
Mathematician.
Invented zero.
Mathematician, yes, he is you know, somebody who contributed to astronomical science as well, but he's a mathematician, right? So what is one of the major contribution of him in the mathematics? Before even the Western mathematician could say this, it was he who thousands of years back had contributed. Very important aspect of mathematics.
He invented zero, sir.
Invented?
Zero.
Zero, very good. What else? It is he who is actually the original father of even geometries. You know, so what do you see here?
Triangle.
A triangle.
Pyramid. Pyramid.
Yeah. Yes, a pyramid, of course, yes. So it's
area of circle.
Huh?
Area of.
Yes, so it is a triangle. When you see triangle, what do you get connected in yoga? What do you see in yoga?
Trikonasana.
Very good. Who said it?
Sir, myself, Babita, faculty from Amani College.
Oh, yes, Babita ma'am. How are you?
Yeah, fine, sir.
Very nice. Thank you. Thank
how
you.
How are good, you doing, good, sir? Yeah. Thank
students
you,
students should come up. All teachers are only every college. That's the problem now. Whenever it would, since yesterday, I have been marathon, yogathon, connecting with various colleges, and the principals are answering. And the, you know, the faculties are answering, students have put off the video and just silently they are giving attendance. Students should come up. The enthusiasm what we teachers are, we should get, come on. So you see a triangle here, right? Very nice. So when you see triangle, so that's what we see, the Trikonasana. So before I could tell about the Trikonasana, we will see the demonstration of Trikonasana. And we are going to have our Disha volunteer doing Trikonasana. Who is going to do the Trikonasana? Bhavana?
Yes, sharing.
Harish ji is going to do Trikonasana. Welcome, Harish ji. Yes, I think Meera will introduce Harish. I think Meera ji or Bhavana will introduce Harish ji, right?
Yes, yes. Okay, just let us view the asana, then we will introduce it.
Yes, yes. Come on, everybody, let's join doing the asana with you.
Jump on the other spread on Kobeko.
Do
Balapadana, Balapta Kobeko, 45 degree. Ama Limdina Volake. Breathe in Usunta Gonda, Usun Pidita, with Hana Wagi, Balabaka, Bagana. Amela Mate, Usunta Gonda, Katana Tirixi Mail, ceiling at the Makaya Nodota, press the money.
Everybody join, do it. Let me see who are doing it. Come on. Don't think I'm not having enough camera. I can't see. Yogis have cameras everywhere. I'm seeing whether you're doing or not.
ಉಸಿರು ಬಿಡ್ತಾ ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಎಡಭಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಬಾರ್ದು
ಮತ್ತೆ ಉಸಿರು ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಕತ್ತನ್ನ ಮೇಲೆತ್ತಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕೈ ಅಥವಾ ಸೀಲಿಂಗ್ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು ಸ್ಥಿತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಸಾಧಾರಣ ಉಸಾಟ ಈ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ನೋಡಿದಂತೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ದೇಹ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್ ಶೇಪ್ ತ್ರಿಭುಜಾಕಾರವಾಗಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಉಸಿರು ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ
ಉಸಿರು ಬಿಟ್ಟ ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಕತ್ತನ್ನ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಬಾಕ್ಸಿ ಕಾಲು ಕೊಡ್ತ ಮೇಲೆ ಪಾದ ಮುಂದೆ ದೇಹ ಮುಂದೆ ಜಂಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ತಾಡಾಸನ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ವಿಶ್ರಾಂತಿ. ಈ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ತ್ರಿಕೋನಾಸನ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸವನ್ನು
ಮಾಡಿ. ಎಸ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಹರೀಶ್ ಜಿ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ತ್ರಿಕೋಣಾಸನ, ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್.
So just to give a brief introduction about Harish Kumarji, he is a very active volunteer in Disha. After finishing his diploma in electrical engineering, he was working with many companies for more than 10-12 years as medical transcriptor. And after that, he wanted to pursue his passion, and then he became a yoga instructor. And today he gives yoga classes in Patanjali Yoga Center in Vijayanagar. So he is one more instructor with excellent sense of humor. He can make you do tough asanas with a smile on your face. So welcome to Harish Kumarji for the session today.
Excellent, wonderful, wonderful. So we see Trikonasana, which is Trikona means a triangle, as you see. Of course, the benefit, the health benefit adds to that. It helps in preventing the flat foot. It strengthens the calf and thigh muscles. It corrects the back problems, strengthen the waist muscles, and makes the spine flexible. So all those are there. But what more important, when you see the trikona, when the triangle you see, what is that you see? At one side, one angle of the trikona is you, the individual. The other angle of the trikona is the jagat, the world that you see. And the third angle is the Ishvara, who is the Paramatma. So Jivatma, Jagat, Paramatma. All these three coming together is what it makes a samashti. The vashti individually, as you are the individual, the jivatma, and the jagat, where we live, the world, and we have a wonderful connection with the world within, where we live. And also, who is the srishti karta of the world, who is called the Lord, the Ishvara, the G-O-D, God, the generator, operator, and the destroyer of the ego. So coming together, all these three is the Trikonasana, what it is indicating, the Trishakti, the Trideha, the Trikala, and all those are indicated in the Trikonasana that we see. Even in our human, I think somebody has to mute your audio. Please mute your audio. So we see in our yoga says, the human body is not only this body what we see. Within this sthula sharira, the gross body, you have the sukshma sharira, the prana, the breathing, the vital energy, the mind, and your intellect, all it forms the part of the sharira. And atma, the anantamaya, is the karana, the causal body. So all these three coming together is what yoga makes it. So that is trikonasana that we have. And next we see a beautiful asana of vajrasana. And who is going to do Vajrasana? I think we have Vajrasana, right?
Now we will practice Vajrasana. The sthiti is Dandasana. Fold the right leg and bring the right heel under the right buttock. Sitting on the right heel, fold the left leg and bring the left heel under the left buttock. Sit erect comfortably with the buttocks resting on both the heels and palms resting on the thighs. In the final posture, the soles of the feet face upwards. Heels are kept together and the entire weight of the body is felt on the back of the feet. Benefits of Vajrasana. It is one of the meditative postures, keeps the spine erect and prevents drowsiness. It facilitates cognitive functions like memory, increases awareness, enhances digestion, and is a very good posture for studies.
Very nice, Shobhaji had done very good Vajrasana. Usually, even in Disha sessions, I always say, whenever you sit in Vajrasana and keep your pustaka in front and study, all that in your pustaka will go to your mastaka. Uploading of knowledge can happen. So it can enhance your memory a lot. Many times friends, students, you know, have this problem. They put a lot of effort in studying, in, you know, remembering things, memorizing, but when they require, they don't recollect. That's a problem, right? Many of us face this problem. Even as we grow older, we face this problem. So the memory blockage is happening because there's a block in the subtle energy channel called Vajranadi. And so we need to open it. When you sit in Vajrasana, you know, when your back like this crossed, and when you sit like this in Vajrasana, the leg crossed, so the Vajranadi gets opened and it facilitates the memory power to a great extent. So that is one another benefit. So we need to do Vajrasana whenever possible. Try to sit in Vajrasana. I always say people in Japan even eat in Vajrasana. This is one asana you can do even while eating, and after eating also when you do, you get wonderful benefits through the Vajrasana. So let's do it always whenever possible. Try to sit in Vajrasana. If you remember, my dear friends, all our prarthana prayers in any religion, it could be we have the prayers, the prarthana being done by sitting in Vajrasana. So this is another wonderful benefit of Vajrasana that we see. Let us see the other asana also. We have
Before we move on, can we quickly, let's have the introduction of the yoga expert who showed us Vajrasana.
Yes.
Yeah. So Srimati Shobha Pomani, our active volunteer yoga expert in Disha, who just showed us what Vajrasana is. I never believed that yoga could keep somebody so young, but I had to believe that after meeting Shobha Pomani ma'am. So one thing about her is, after she finished her graduation, she went on to pursue her passion in yoga. She finished her yoga instructor course, and then she's also finished her counseling course and life instructors, life skill course from Banjara Academy. She's also a director in her company, Maharaja Buildtech. And one very special thing about Shobha ma'am is, she also secured gold medal in Vivekananda yoga competition as well. So that's active volunteer Shobha Pomani ma'am for you today. Welcome ma'am. Welcome ma'am to the session.
Very good. Very good. Very good. Excellent. Disha is always proud of all such wonderful volunteers. And yes, next we will continue to do that because she has already shared the benefits and I have also added to that. So we will go to the next asana, which is Ushtrasana. And who is going to do the Ushtrasana? Questions are coming only from Abhishek Pandey. Many others should also ask questions. Yeah, Abhishek, very good. I will answer you, Yoganidra.
ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ಉಷ್ಟ್ರಾಸನಕ್ಕೆ ವಜ್ರಾಸನಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋಣ. ಕಾಲನ್ನ ಮಲಗಾಲನ್ನ ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ಮೇಲೆ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಆದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಎಡಗಾಲನ ಮೇಲೆ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ. ಇದು ವಜ್ರಾಸನ. ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಸುತ್ತ ಹೊರಡ್ತಾ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಂಡಿ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರೋಣ. ಹಾಗೆ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಸುತ್ತ ಹೊರಡ್ತಾ ಬಲಗೈನ ಮೊದಲಿಗೆ ಸ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹಿಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎಡಗೈನ ಸ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹಿಂದೆ ಈ ಥರ ಸ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೋಗಕ್ ಆಗದೆ ಇರೋರು ಸೊಂಟದ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೈ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ನಿಧಾನ ಹಿಂದೆ ಬಾಗಿ, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕೈಯನ್ನ ಕಾಲ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡಿ. ಇದು ಈ ತರ ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ. ಸ್ಥಿತಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಬೀದಿ ಉಸಿರಾಟ, ಮತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹವನ್ನ ಗಮನಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೇಕು. ಹಾಗೆ ಮುಂದೆ ವಜ್ರಾಸನಕ್ಕೆ ವಾಪಸ್
ಎಕ್ಸಲೆಂಟ್, ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸನ? ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ದೆನ್ ಐ ಗೋ ಟು ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಶಶಾಂಕ್ ಆಸನ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ರೈಟ್? ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಶಶಾಂಕ್ ಆಸನ ಆಲ್ಸೋ? ಭಾವನಾ, ಲಾವಣ್ಯ,
ನೌ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಸ್ ಶಶಾಂಕಾಸನ. ದ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಇಸ್ ದಂಡಾಸನ. fold the right leg at the knees and then the left leg and sit on the heels in Vajrasana, resting the palms on thighs. Take the hands behind the back, make a fist of the right palm and hold the right wrist with the left palm. Relax the shoulders. Inhale, lean backwards a little from the waist, opening up the chest. Exhale, slowly bend forward from the waist, bringing the forehead on the ground in front of the knees. Collapse the shoulders. Maintain this position for about 1 minute with normal breathing. Inhale, slowly come up to the vertical position. Release your hands and come back to sthiti. Relax in Shitila Dandasana. Benefits: enhances blood flow at the head, stimulates the brain, gives flexibility to the spine, ankles and knees. A good posture for breathing ailments. Limitations: patients with gastritis and peptic ulcer may avoid this posture.
That was wonderful that we could see all this different postures from all of our Disha volunteers. So we have seen some of the samples of the wonderful asanas that we have, more around 84 lakhs of asanas which are being demonstrated and taught by none other than the Adi Yogi Shiva himself. You know, we see in the Shiva Samhita and Garuda Samhita, the yoga scriptures, Lord Shiva, who is called the Adi Yogi himself, teaching yoga to Parvati and then to Mashendranatha. That's how the parampara of yoga goes, where all these asanas are taught by Shiva. So out of that, we have seen a few here, and this especially Ushtrasana, when you bend backward, Sashankasana, when you bend forward, it enhances the memory for students, the blood flow, the oxygen supply increases more, whereby you become more energetic, alert. And even for women, nowadays young girls come with lot of problem like PCOD and all, and then after they grow, post-marital life, they have lot of issues. So all these, when you do the asanas of Vajrasana, Ushtrasana, Sashankasana, these help a lot, especially in the gynec health as well, my dear friends. And more than that, for students, for the memory, for concentration, for enhancing their cognitive faculties, these are wonderful asanas. So if we do all this, we can make our body to be flexible. Yes, definitely one, but it's not about only making the body flexible, but it needs to prepare the body for, the calmness of mind, the enhancement of the pranic energy that we need to feel. And it is all about connecting our internal nature with the external nature. So of course, much more to share. Time is limited because of the technical difficulty. If we meet you one-to-one, when we see each other, the faces and chair, it is a different experience. But the screen talk is sometimes very difficult. So we are inhibited sometimes about the flow of the ideas and thoughts. So here I try to stop here, so that because we have the talk by our international yoga guru, our Guruji, my mentor, and the president for Disha, we have Sri Raghuramji, who is going to share his ideas on this International Day of Yoga. He's so busy with lot of events happening day and night, because when it is night for us, it is day for America. So people want his sessions. So almost all yoga gurus are working day and night and spreading yoga through this yoga day to keep up the positivity for people. That's how Raghuramji is also doing. We will go ahead in listening to Raghuramji. And before that, I would like to add a few words about him. Raghuramji is, of course, well-known yoga guru in the world of yoga. He's one of the founding members of the S. Vyasa Yoga University. My dear friends, you have heard of yoga today. Even in my introduction, Miraji told about me that I did my master's and doctorate and all from S. Vyasa and the Hindu University of America. And Raghuramji is one of the founding members of both these institutions. And he's somebody, a pioneer in taking yoga from India way back, you know, early in the early 60s and 70s to United States and to Europe and to various countries. And he was a personal yoga trainer for the first astronaut from India, Rakesh Sharma. And to many, he was responsible for introducing yoga in the White House in the USA. And to various countries that he had taken. And his wife, Dr. Nagaratna, is also the pioneer in the field of yoga therapy. So both of them together has been spreading yoga everywhere to door and shore to shore. And Raghuramji is a wonderful motivational speaker, had been delivering wonderful spiritual discourses in many forums, you know, in many countries, official parliament and, you know, the Senate and everywhere he had been invited to give the talks. And he is a profound meditator and teacher of meditation. He has introduced yoga to even countries like Turkey, to, you know, all those places. Even today, if they all welcome the yoga day, his work has been very much there. So, you know, years together of tapasya that he has done. And he also, from engineering, took this human engineering of yoga, and he is spreading it world over, Sri Raghuramji. And it's our privilege that he is the president for Disha Charitable Trust also. And for years, right from the inception of Disha, Raghuramji has been guiding all of our volunteers and the office bearers. So it's our pleasure to have him. This yoga day, he's so busy with so many programs. In spite of it, he has taken his interest and had given his message for this beautiful yoga day. We listen to his message, and he's going to be with us to answer all the, you know, questions that you have. Already we have line of questions with Abhishek Pandey and Padmavati, and others have shared here. And me and Raghuramji, we will take up all the questions and answer all your questions. Yes. So I think we will listen to Raghuramji now.
Namaste, everyone. My greetings on behalf of Disha on this wonderful occasion of International Day of Yoga. This is one festival which belongs to the whole world. It does not pertain to one particular caste or creed, one particular religion or belief. It's one particular age group or the other. It is something which is the whole world follows, and that's what is the International Day of Yoga. And today happens to be the longest day, and that is why we are celebrating this International Day of Yoga. The significance of this International Day of Yoga is the importance that yoga gained in the last about 100 years, ever since Swami Vivekananda introduced this yoga into the international forum. And from there, it has slowly, steadily picked up. Several yogis from India have gone around the whole world, spread this message. Today, there is no country where people do not know about yoga. And it does not belong to any particular class of people, but it is for everybody. And not only that, the kind of enthusiasm that International Day of Yoga has caught, the spirit of, whether they are the actors, whether they are the VIPs, the politicians, educators, and students, everybody on the forum, they're all practicing the idea of yoga. Because the idea of practicing International Day of Yoga is because of these three important reasons. One is the health, second is the harmony, and third is the peace. And these three qualities, health, harmony, and peace, they are with us, all within us as part of our own being. They are not coming from outside, they are within us. Again, when we have this idea of health, harmony, and peace as a part of this International Day of Yoga, it is not just this day that we practice, that this day that we think of this, but this is the day that it reminds us that this has been the way that we are supposed to be living in our life. So therefore, it's a yoga lifestyle. All other practices are the practices that people do, like, for example, gym, exercise, and puja, meditation. All those things are something what people do. But yoga is supposed to be a lifestyle. In this culture, ever since it started from the time that immemorial, this practice of yoga or the ideas of yoga has been part of this particular culture. Only thing is Patanjali, he has come on later on. He gave us the sutras, that means to say formulae of yoga, so that we are now know very clearly that what is this practice of yoga. Now what happens is that so many people have taken yoga in so many different ways and ideas all over the world. But now this practice that now it has become International Day of Yoga, what we are trying to come to is the most scientific aspect of yoga and to see that how it can reach the people, mankind. When it is the scientific way, then it does not belong to any particular religion, region, caste or some individuals. Like for example, physics, chemistry, these are all sciences, and then they don't belong to any place. Maybe Einstein comes from Germany and he has given us a theory of relativity, but we don't take it that theory of relativity belongs to German and we are Indians, we can't take it. It does not belong to any region. Newton was in England and he has given us this law of gravity apart from various other things. But look at the way that what he has given became the part of the whole universe. The same way that yoga might have emerged from this particular land, from this particular culture, but it does not have to confine itself to this place. Therefore, basically now with several research papers published and all those things, now yoga has now gone beyond the boundaries of this country, beyond the boundaries of the text, which were there in Sanskrit, because originally all these things are written in Sanskrit. But now yoga is something which is translated into all the languages of the world. Books are there, literature is there, research work has been done. I would look at this particular International Day of Yoga as an important tool to see that this practice, that it gets into the people. Maybe that in the future that everybody involves in some kind of other, either it is in the laboratory with the help of equipment and the research, or the research within himself, his own personality. I have such great anecdotal experiences about this yoga being practiced. In fact, when one of the ladies who participated in our yoga teacher training program in Turkey, her husband, one day when we were going together someplace, he said that ever since my wife has taken yoga, we have seen so much of harmony in our family. See, that means to say that it has its effect, whether you notice it or not, it will definitely be changing the whole world. I wish that today in this world, which is ridden with all those religious faiths and beliefs and trying to kill each other in the name of religion, if we can really bring the people together, there's one tool which can unite them, and that's what is the tool called as yoga. Swami Vivekananda way back said, more wars are fought in the name of religion and faith than any other cause. So that gave the indication that is there a opportunity for us to raise from the level of religion and casteism and this and that, and one practice all over the world which can take us beyond that is yoga. Provided we start doing yoga, not just only simple physical practices, but to see that we have asanas at the body level, kriyas at body level, pranayama at the prana level, various meditation practices at the mind level, and we also have intellectual understanding called as jnana yoga, emotional stabilization called as bhakti yoga. Like that, all the different steps, stages of yoga, working at various personality levels on us, when we are able to take this message to the world, probably the world will be a better place and holistic way that we can grow the development of yoga. Apart from that, there is another very important reason why yoga becomes very important is that World Health Organization way back 20, 30, 40 years ago, they had this idea that the whole medical practice should rise from the level of treating the sickness to recognizing the well-being. So therefore they said it is not mere absence of sickness, but it's a positive well-being. And if people want to have that positive well-being, they must have a tool which can maintain that positive well-being of an individual. And that's what is yoga. So it is not that yoga has to be practiced for the sake of sickness, but to see that I maintain the health, I take care of the health, we need to grow. Actually, very important aspect is that with the help of yoga, that health enters into us, the sickness goes away. Like the way that the moment that the light enters inside, the darkness goes away. This is what his charaka has given us the analogy, and we can use that particular thing so that from psychological point of view, we take away the sickness aspect within us and we start feeling healthy. The more and more that we feel healthy, the more and more that we can bring that healthy health in our life. Ayurveda also says that ahara, vichara and your vyavahara, all these things to be in a healthy way. So this is what is the idea of yoga. Whether it is you take the practice of karma yoga, jnana yoga, or whether you take the practice of yama, niyama of the raja yoga, or sitting in meditation of the mindfulness, any of these practices that you take, you see that they all touch the core of your being, and that's what is yourself. There cannot be any way that you can remain to be a person who is a bad character when we have taken the yoga as a way of life. So it is this which has prompted that the whole of Indian culture survived for 7,000, 8,000 years, so vibrant way. It is because that these things are the part of our own way of life. So let us bring back. I feel that this particular yoga as a lifestyle we bring back to the world, greatest contribution of Indian culture to the world around. And we are ready to give that idea to the world. And with these practices that we are doing, International Day of Yoga has been designed with a small little a program where it has given a few practices together. Yes, today we do that so that we have uniformity all over the world. But at the same time, we see that yoga is a vast science, ocean of knowledge that is there. Let this be the beginning of our journey. And let's make on our own the journey in such a way that we go into all the details and depth of yoga so that we'll be able to bring about a total all-round personality development. With this, basically, that we are able to reach the world, we are able to reach the whole aspect of the world, whether it is young or old. In a process that this we started all these things, let this yoga, with our all efforts of International Day of Yoga and taking this yoga further, let it become like part of a curriculum for the school students all over the world. Without any reservation, let's all develop this yoga, practice this yoga, improve our health, improve our well-being, and improve the peace and harmony, interpersonal relationship. With these few words, what Disha has already been giving, values in the life in the name of Disha programs, this also becomes part of that Disha program. Therefore, all our camps, all our courses, we always include yoga as essential part of this journey of Disha, the direction that we're giving. Once again, may all the yogis from ancient lore, all the rishis who have given us this great vision, let them all bless us. Let them all say to us eloquently, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha. And with the help of yoga, you can achieve that. Namaste.
Wonderful, wonderful message that we got from our Guruji, Sri Raghuramji. I think that sums up the whole idea of what yoga is and today how it is relevant in today's life and what is that message that we need to carry and apply in our day-to-day living. Is a beautiful direction that Sri Raghuramji has given us. And on behalf of Disha, all our volunteers and all the colleges who are participating, we offer our pranams to Guruji, Sri N.V. Raghuramji. Is Raghuramji here with us, Meeraji?
No, Subhuji, he is not here with us.
No, he is not here. We don't see him as a participant.
Okay. So, I think we will, you know, take up some of the Meeraji. If we, you know, I think we will take up some of the questions which are there.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we will answer that, and then maybe with a small winding up a meditation that we can conclude.
Yes. Yes.
Meanwhile, if Raghuramji is able to join us, you know, he can also answer any other questions. So, I think Abhishek Pandey has some questions. Abhishek has, before that, Padmavati Aishwarya has asked a question, what is the right time to do yoga, right? Very nice question. In fact, in the ancient context, if you see, yoga was not something which is to be done at a particular time. Yoga was life, yoga was jivana, yoga was part and parcel of our life. So there was no particular time they would go and do. If you see the asanas which we were doing, if you do 1 minute an asana, it's a great thing. If you do for a few more minutes, it's an achievement, we get certificates and medals. But the yogis, they were standing in one leg for days together, years together, and they were doing. Meditation was something constantly which was happening for them. So yoga was not limited to time in the ancient context. In the context of spirituality, if you see, yoga is something which happens all the time. You need to live the life of yoga all the time. There is no separate time for it. So whenever you are breathing, we are doing pranayama. Whenever you are, you know, consciously aware of what you are doing, that's where, you know, the awareness is again yoga. So we are sitting, you know, in whichever posture you are sitting. When you are normally sitting, even that's an asana, that's sukhasana. When you lie down, even that is shavasana, right? So even the food what we eat is yoga. Yuktahara viharasya. Abhishek has asked a question about sattvic bhojana. Even the food is part of yoga. So when, you know, Krishna says even unmishan, nimishan, abhi, even the, you know, winking of eyes, opening of eyes, and every activity, even visrujan, even the excretion what we do, yoga can be done in everything. Yogastha kuru karmani. Krishna says in the Gita, do everything that you do with a sense of yogic attitude. Yoga is not what limited to time. It is a sadbhavana, that attitude with which we do the yoga, that is more important. So in this context, when we see yoga is not limited to time, we have all life is yoga. Sri Aurobindo says all life is yoga. But coming to the yoga abhyasa, the yoga asana, the pranayama abhyasa that we need to do, yes. We can have in our normal context. I told you in the adhyatmic context, there is no time limit. In fact, the yogi, sometimes there's a shloka in the Gita where Krishna says, Yanisha sarvabhutanam tasyam jagrati sayami. When it is night for the normal people, yogis are awakened. They may sit and meditate. Shri Ram Krishna and Vivekar, there are different contextual meanings for this shloka in different way. But I would like to take a very mundane meaning, that even the night of, you know, normal people is a day for yogis. So when we all sleep, the yogis sit and meditate in the night. So it is like that there is no exact time limit for it. But when it comes to abhyasa, that normally as we lay people, normal people, we need to do, there need to be a proper time and procedure for yoga, which is important. Yoga is anushasanam. And when you see in that regard, the sandhya kala, the morning, the Brahma Muhurta, first of all, which is starting from 4 a.m. From 4 a.m. onwards, it's an anukula time for any adhyatmic sadhana, for yoga also. And the sandhya, which is, you know, exactly at 6 a.m. when we say the rise of sun. So that is a beautiful time for the practice of yoga. And in the evening also, the sayam sandhya, the evening sandhya time is also a good time for doing yoga. But nowadays it's convenience, anukula, we are making according to our own convenience. People ask us, you know, can you teach yoga? If somebody comes and asks me, 9 o'clock do we have a batch? I said 9 a.m. but no, 9 p.m. you have a batch. Why? Because my office ends at 9 p.m. I can come do 1 hour yoga, and gyms are operating like this. That's how they think yoga, but that's not the right way to do. If at all you have to do abhyasa, morning, at the most up to 7, 8 o'clock is the time from 4 a.m. and evening post 6 up to at the most 8 is the time limit for our regular yoga abhyasa. You know, because in the night, we see that the Surya, we are talking of Surya in the context of the yoga day, longest day. So Surya emanates different kirana, different races in different time. What in the morning, the Surya's kirana comes in the early morning, the Ushat Kala, that is Gau Kirana, the sattvic rays of the sun. In the daytime, it's Ashva Kirana, the horse rays of the sun. In the night, it is the Sarpa Kirana, which is the tamasic rays of the sun, which is poisonous. So we need to be doing the sadhana in the Gokirana, the early morning time, which is more important. So that is about how to do, what time to do yoga. And next there's the question of what is Sattvika Bhojana? Very nice question. In fact, Krishna again in the Gita very well tells the Tamasic, Rajasic and Sattvic Bhojana. Sattvic Bhojana is something which is fresh, first of all. Not pre-cooked and stored, it's fresh, you know, with more of clean vegetables, and often as our Nagaratna Didi would add, TTT, Tatte Tumba Tarkari, had fresh vegetables and fruits. So those are called anything that would go stale, pungent. So all these are not Sattvic Bhojana. And the right way to eat is eat when you are hungry. Don't go sticking like in yoga abhyasa. I told time is important. With regard to food, is don't get conditioned only to time. Time is important, but also feed your stomach only when you feel hungry. And when you feed, find out whether it is the stomach which is wanting the food or your tongue which is wanting the food. If your tongue is wanting, you know, do not yield to that. Stomach is wanting, give that. There's a right way of eating the right food. Of course, Sattvic food is absolutely vegetarian food. And even avoid, in yoga, we avoid even onion, garlic, and all those things which give you kind of more of tamasic pragrati. And therefore, that is the right food. And how much water to drink. As per yogic philosophy doesn't talk particularly more about how much water to drink, though ahara, mitahara, and all those are spoken in the Hatha Yoga scriptures, but specifically about water, there is nothing. But eventually, you know, by practice, all the yoga masters have come to, you know, kind of a thing that not less than 4 liters of water a day that we need to drink on an average. And do not drink water along with the food. That's a bad habit many of us have. Even I do this, that whenever we are eating, we sip water in between. So avoid drinking water along with the food, and it could be an independent act. And to keep us hydrated, often drink water. That is more important. And I'll come back to Abhishek's question of what is Yoga Nidra. And before that, some other question I'll take. Amrita has asked, I have a question. Can yoga cure insomnia, lack of sleep? Yes, that's where. Now, Abhishek's question and Amrita's question goes hand in hand. She has asked about insomnia, which is lack of sleeplessness. Which is many of us today, either, you know, we are facing this problem in today's generation. You don't get to sleep at home, but come and sit in a wonderful workshop like this, you can get sleep. People are making lullaby for you. And moreover, in colleges, when you go and sit, you can sleep. People sleep in Vidhan Sauda and all those places also. So there's a problem. There is insomnia. One is not getting sleep. Sleep apnea is not getting sleep at the appropriate time and place, but getting it in the wrong time and wrong place. So these two kind of problems which are there, and yoga offers definitely a solution for that. And that is what is Yoga Nidra. Yoga Nidra is nothing but the relaxation completely that you have to take for the whole body. Even in the body, that every cell that we have, in the body, the physical body, we have what we see is called the sthula sharira, the gross body, the sukshma sharira, the internal organs, what we have, the systems that we have, the anatomical systems, they form the sukshma of the annamaya kosha, sukshma of the sthula sharira itself. And the cells that we have, they form the karana for the annamaya kosha, the physical body. So deep into cellular level, the yoga nidra takes you and puts you into sleep. Every cell, every, you know, nerves of the body, every part of the body to sleep. So yoga nidra is the intense relaxation process through guided instruction that you can learn. Abhishek, I'm happy to see your interest, and even with Amrita. It's not something which I can just like that, you know, overly say. You need to practice, get learnt. Now we are offering a lot of such programs during this pandemic situation, a lot of online sessions of Yoga Nidra we are offering. I can share you our details. You can practice that. So Yoga Nidra definitely help us to attain a wonderful equanimity, a balance in sleep also. How long should we sleep? So it is definitely that yoga helps us that, you know, that even with reduced amount of sleep, energy is compensated, you know. So we have a beautiful technique, even cyclic meditation from Espyasa, Avartana Dhyana. The research findings show that 35 minutes of this meditation gives you a sleep which is equivalent to 6 hours of sleep. So when you do 6 hours of sleep, what amount of rest that we get by doing 35 minutes of meditation that you can get. That's why you see, you know, the yogis, including our Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, our Guruji, Dr. H.R. Nagendraji, gets up at 2:30 in the morning, and he's so alert all throughout the day. He's already near he is 80 and more energetic that we see with him. So the yogi people sleep less, but they work more energetic because of the energy which is otherwise produced, the relaxation otherwise produced by doing the meditation. Yes. And yes, now we have asked one question. Bhavita has asked us, how do we address? Yeah.
Bhavana here.
Yes.
From our Facebook Live, we have Muralidhar ji asking one question.
Please.
For stammering, is there any specific yoga?
For?
Stammering.
Stammering. Okay, yeah. Stammering, you know, I don't think a particular thing which is proven, but definitely there are practices which can help to reduce the frequency of stammering. We have a wonderful practice set of voice culture, you know, especially the pranayamas where the tongue is used, the throat is used. For example, Sheetali Shitkari Sadanta practices, and we have the Ujjayi pranayama, which is very much there. And all these can help in the voice culture practices, which is more important. And we have the Simha Mudra and all those things. The voice culture, it's a technique, it's a set of practice. So all those put together can definitely help. And how long should we do? You know, that is important. I'll tell you about that. So it is not like, so what happened, unfortunately, today people, we have this allopathic mind. When we had headache, which medicine can I take? When I have a back pain, what medicine can I take? If I have a knee pain, which treatment can I take? So yoga offers you actually a holistic thing. It looks at you as a human being, as a holistic thing. That's what we learned. I'm not just the head. I'm not just the eye. I'm not just the finger. But I am this Vyashti. I am the whole human. And when I get connected with the cosmic energy, the healing can happen with us. This Vyashti to Samashti is that what yoga can offer us. So we need to look into this, not look into one aspect, what it can, whether it can heal my head, it can set right. But people will ask, what can I do to avoid hair fall? Is there any yoga for it? Huh? And how can I, you know, for reduction of weight, for gaining weight, all these things, that's a, you know, approach which people are looking for. But I tell you, my dear friends, when you take yoga as a holistic thing and do everything, start with the Sukshma Vyayama, the breathing practices, and then do the Surya Namaskara, do a set of asanas, minimum at least 5-10 asanas a day, and then do some pranayama, do shavasana, the relaxation. All this will help us in overall health, overall well-being. Then you don't have to particularly go for each one, you know, as a compartmental aspect. Definitely there is treatment for all these also. A lot of researches are coming up day by day. And for stammering also, there are wonderful techniques which, and then chantings, that is more important in stammering. The Avu, Akara, Ukara, Makara chanting, the mantra chanting can help a lot. So you can, you know, contact us for getting more details of the therapeutic measures which can help you. And I will take one last question here. How do we address anxiety, which is generated during the COVID-19 crisis? Very wonderful question, Babitaji. Because today, during the situation, people are facing a lot of problems. And even though we don't have, you know, but what will happen to me? Will the virus come and attack me? You know, so that kind of anxiety that all of us do have. So how do we handle that, right? Again, yoga is mana prashamana upayaha. It's a technique to calm down the mind. So we need to meditate. The simple meditation technique. I will just now quickly teach you. All of you sit straight, eyes closed. Just relax your whole body. Just observe the whole body from the tip of the toe to the top of the head. Observe the whole body. So feel each and every part of the body and mentally relax your body. Slowly shift your awareness to your tip of the nostril and observe your breathing. Observe the normal, natural breathing. Observe the breathing. Slow inhalation and slow exhalation. Take a deep breath, slowly inhale. And exhale slowly. Inhale slowly. Exhale slowly. Feel the beautiful breathing. Retain the awareness on the tip of the nostril. Observe the breathing. The more slower we breathe, the calmer the mind becomes. And bring a mental affirmation. Say to yourself, I'm free from all stress. I'm free from all worries and tension. I'm healthy, better. Make a sankalpa. Take a determination. Say to yourself, my immunity is stronger. My respiration is stronger. Try to feel an aura all around. Feel the protection all around. To relax, to enhance energy, let's chant one round of Avuma chanting.
Subhuji, your audio is not audible. Your voice is not audible, Subhuji. Subhuji, your voice is not audible.
Subhuji, you are not audible. We are not able to hear you, Subhuji.
Subhuji, your voice is not audible. No.
You put us on camera.
Subhuji, you're not audible.
Re-login, Madi, Subhuji. Re-login, Madi.
Subhuji, you're not audible.
No. Issue.
Okay. Sushma ma'am, do we have you here?
Hello?
Sushma ma'am? Sushma?
Yeah.
Kubuji's connection. I think his bandwidth problems. So I take this opportunity to thank one and all who participated in this Disha's first yoga and live or online session which we conducted. It was a wonderful opportunity for all of us in Disha also to be part of this. I take this opportunity to thank Subbu Bhaiya ji from Adhyatma Yoga. I also take this opportunity to thank our Disha president Raghuram ji for sending wonderful message across. I also take this opportunity to thank Rupa Vasudevan from Best University for giving us the technical support. I also want to thank Arbindo College, Shailaja ma'am for this, who supported us. This was the first of its kind for us. It was an Subhuji, are you back?
No, that's okay. I think that's okay. We were done, I think.
Yeah.
I was completing the meditation, so I think there was a problem. Are you able to hear me now?
Subhuji.
Yes.
Subhuji, I think Sushma is doing the thanking. After that, you complete the yoga. 2 minutes.
Yeah, please. Yeah,
go ahead. After that, you finish the yoga for us. Please wait.
Yes,
please wait for 2 moments. Yes.
Yeah, please.
Go ahead, Sushma.
Yeah. Thank you. I take this opportunity to thank Subhuji again. You had missed the thanking when I was going ahead. So thank you, Subhuji, for a wonderful 1.5 hour session you have given us. Despite the busy schedule you are going through due to this pandemic, you have been doing yoga 24/7, I believe. So thank you so much. I also take this opportunity to thank all the volunteers who were part of our yoga demonstrations and other Disha volunteers. I also take this opportunity to thank Sarjan from Best University team who stood by us and supported us through the day. Now also we've been a part of this 1.5 hour journey. So I thank Sarjan also for this wonderful support he has given us. Thank you so much. I take this opportunity Subhuji to finish his with wherever he had left from. Yes. Go on, Subhuji.
Okay. I don't know, where we are there and trying to give you some kind of relaxation and meditation. I think that's okay. Only thing I want to tell you is, yoga is not one day, as we say, it's not one day matram. It's one day matram. Every day that we need to continue the practice of yoga, that is more important. And somebody was asking, can I get quick relief for this? Whether it can cure this problem, that problem. Yes, it can happen, but we need to have patient practice. Sadhana, tapasya is more important. We need to do it, and continuous perseverance practice if we do, we can get good results. So yoga day is not the one day. One day we are doing to get an inspiration, a motivation, but it should be all days that we continue to do. That is important. Let's take a sankalpa. We all should take a sankalpa that this yoga, what I have, what little bit today I have taken inspiration to do. So I take the sankalpa to continue this practice on every day. That is important. That's where even during these difficult times, it's difficult to continue the online sessions and everything. But we are trying to do, because at least something is better than nothing. So instead of staying home alone without doing anything, let's reach out to people and do. This year, as you know, the yoga day theme has been yoga at home, yoga with family. So tomorrow being the yoga day, we have a lot of sessions. If you permit me, Rekha ji and Veera, I'll just show you the event which is going to happen tomorrow.
Go on.
Yeah, so that you can all, of course, many have left, but for the benefit of all who are here, you know, I will just share you about tomorrow what Yoga Day program that we are doing, so that you can get just a minute. I will open the slide and show you the program for tomorrow. So I invite all of you to join with us in these yoga demonstrations. Tomorrow morning, 6 to 7, we have one yoga common session where you can all, you know, kind of participate. And 7 to 8, we are reaching out through, you know, channel called Sri Shankara Vahini. So we have a program called the Yoga Bhumi. So where in a unique way, we have almost 30 yoga teachers coming together from their own respective ashrams and places, like way today we were doing. Disha, we are all from different places. We are reaching out to you, giving this program. So tomorrow we are going to have all the yoga teachers coming to you, teaching yoga to your home. So you can all watch us live and do yoga with us. Just please watch.
This June 21st, International Yoga Day, let us enter into the world of yoga. Yoga embeds both fitness and wellness. Join us to practice yoga with over 15 renowned yoga groups from the safety of your home. Watch Shankara Pallavi's
Supuji, again, there is a connectivity issue. Okay. We are not leaving. Oh my God, it's the bottom.
No, Supuji, we are not able to hear you. Namaste, namaste.
I think Lavanya, we can conclude the program.
Yes, yes, okay. Yes.
Yeah, we will just conclude the small shloka.
Yeah, we will conclude the program.
Yes, yes, yes. All of you will just tell the shloka and conclude. Subhuji is not audible. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. Sarve santu niramayah, sarve madrani pashyantu, akashchit sukha bhavet.
Thank you all.
Thank you all. Thank you all so much for participation.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Namaste. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Patmala. Subhuji,
come online.
Hello, are you acting like that? Never upset that.
Shazil ji and team, can we end the meeting?